Very good morning to students. In this lecture, we are going to discuss about IoT and M2M. M2M is machine to machine network. Outline of this lecture is M2M, difference and similarities between M2M and IoT, SDN and NFV for IoT. SDN and NFV are the models we are using in IoT. So coming to the M2M, already we know M2M is machine to machine. Machine to machine refers to networking of machines for the purpose of remote monitoring and control and data exchange. Here in the diagram, we are observing that different networks. So M2M refers to networking of machines. Machines networking is known as M2M. Important points about M2M. An M2M area network comprises of machines, also known as nodes, which have embedded hardware modules for sensing, actuation and communication. So in M2M, machines have hardware modules for sensing, actuation and communication. Various communication protocols can be used for M2M local area networks, namely ZigBee, Bluetooth, Modbus, MBus, wireless MBus, power line communication, 6LoWPAN, IEEE 802.15.4, etc. The communication network provides connectivity to remote MTM area networks. The communication network can use either wired or wireless networks. It can be used to either wired or wireless networks. While the M2M area networks use either proprietary or non-IP based communication protocols, the communication network uses IP based networks. M2M gateway. Gateway is already we have the conceptual idea through which we can communicate. Since non-IP based protocols are used within M2M area networks, the M2M nodes within one network cannot communicate with the nodes in an external network. So one node of one network cannot communicate in another node of another network. To enable the communication between remote M2M area networks, M2M gateways are used. In this, we saw the diagrammatic presentation. In this, native protocol, protocol translation, proxy, M2M gateway. Difference between IoT and M2M. So M2M is networking of nodes or machines, whereas IoT is the things of internet things. Communication protocols. M2M and IoT can differ in how the communication between the machines or devices happens. M2M uses either proprietary or non-IP based communication protocols for communication within the M2M area networks. So M2M uses non-IP based communication protocols. Machines in M2M versus things in IoT. The things in IoT refers to physical objects that have unique identifiers and can communicate with their external environment or their internal physical states. M2M systems, in contrast to IoT, typically have homogeneous machines types within an M2M area network. Hardware versus software emphasis. While the emphasis of M2M is more on hardware with embedded modules, the emphasis of IoT is more on software. So IoT focus on software, whereas M2M focus on hardware with modules. Data collection and analysis. M2M data is collected in point solutions and often in on-premises storage infrastructure. In contrast to M2M, the data in IoT is collected in the cloud. Can be public or private or hybrid cloud. Applications. M2M data is collected in point solutions and can be accessed by on-premises applications such as diagnosis applications, service management applications, and on-premises enterprise applications. IoT data is collected in the cloud and can be accessed by cloud applications such as analytics applications, enterprise applications, remote diagnosis and management applications, etc. Communication in IoT versus M2M. So already we in the introduction class the general idea of the IoT, it has three layers: application, transport, network and link layer presented. Again the different layers of the model. So IoT and M2M, primary point to point. So that is in between the network and link layers, and IoT is the difference of the application layer. So SDN. So software defined network. SDN is a networking architecture that separates the control panel from the data plane and centralizes the network control. So the data plane is separated from the control plane. Software based SDN controllers maintain a unified view of the network and make configuration management and provisioning simpler. The underlying infrastructure in SDN uses simple packet forwarding hardware as opposed to specialized hardware in conventional networks. So underlying infrastructure uses simple packet forwarding hardware as opposed to specialized hardware in conventional model. We observe in the diagram infrastructure layer consisting of simple packet forwarding hardware. So it's a southbound open API, also known as open flow, and this is the network operating system control layer. Northbound open API. So application layer has network applications. Key elements of SDN. So we observe that three elements: centralized network controller, programmable open APIs, standard communication interface. So in the centralized network controller, with decoupled control and data planes and centralized network controller, the network administrators can rapidly configure the network. Programmable open APIs. SDN architecture supports programmable open API for interface between the SDN application and control layers, northbound interface, and standard communication interface, open flow. SDN architecture used a standard communication interface between the control and infrastructure layers. So that is the southbound interface. Open flow, which is defined by the Open Network Foundation, is the broadly accepted SDN protocol for the southbound interface. So the next one is the NFV. Network function virtualization is a technology that leverages virtualization to consolidate the heterogeneous network devices onto industry standard high volume servers, switches and storage. So network function virtualization NFV is a technology that leverages virtualization to consolidate the heterogeneous network devices onto industry standard high volume servers, switches and storage. NFV is complementary to SDN as NFV can provide the infrastructure on which SDN can run. So this is the observation. Virtual compute, virtual network, virtual storage, NFV infrastructure we observe. In the virtualization layer, compute, network, storage. So virtual network functions, NFV management and orchestration. The key elements of NFV, virtualization network function, VNF, NFV architecture, infrastructure, NFV management and orchestration. VNF is a software implementation of network function which is capable of running over the NFV infrastructure. NFVI includes compute, network and storage resources that are virtualized. NFV management orchestration focuses on all virtualization specific management tasks and covers the orchestration and lifecycle management of physical and software resources that support the infrastructure virtualization and the lifecycle management of VNFs. Okay, last one. NFV use case. NFV can be used to virtualize the home gateway. The NFV infrastructure in the cloud hosts a virtualized home gateway. The virtualization gateway provides private IP address to the devices in the home. The virtualized gateway also connects to network services such as VoIP and IPTV. So this is the diagrammatic presentation. Public network, virtualized home gateway and internet and NFV infrastructure. These are the whatever things of the home controlled by the ISP. Thank you for this class and patience listening. We'll meet in the next class. Thank you.